Take a look at this picture. This is of Elizabeth Escalona and her 2-year-old daughter. This is Jocelyn Cedillo in, obviously, happier times. Back on September 7th, Jocelyn was rushed to a hospital in Dallas, Texas. She was covered in bruises. Her ribs and a leg were broken. She had a concussion. This little one was in a coma, and at one point, she wasn't even expected to live. Jocelyn not only survived, she was just released from the hospital, but her 22-year-old mother is sitting in jail, held on $500,000 bond, and what Dallas police say is an extreme case of child abuse, some going as far as calling it torture. Here's what the Dallas Police Department says is among the things Jocelyn's mother is accused of doing. Dragging the 2-year-old by her feet from the kitchen, putting glue on her little hands and sticking them to the wall, taking a jug of milk and hitting the toddler in the stomach with it. Police say this was punishment for the child soiling her pants. I want to bring in Dallas crime reporter Tanya Iser. Tanya, you have been covering the story for the Dallas Morning News. Like I said, Dallas police say this is clearly a case of excessive child abuse. First, just I have to ask, how is Jocelyn?
As far as we know, she's doing much better. One of the police officers I know that's been involved in the case said that Jocelyn is an example of how, you know, resilient children are. You know, last week things were looking really bad, but this week she's made dramatic improvements. She's walking, she's responding to touch and sound, and of course she's out of the hospital and in foster care with her siblings, from what I understand.
What is it that sets this case apart? I mean, some are saying it was a miracle she survived.
I think what sets it apart is the glue. The emails that I've received from readers, they really respond to the issue of the glue. You know, the gluing, you know, putting the glue on the child's hands and then pressing her hands against the wall, that's really shocking to people. Unfortunately, in my many years as a police reporter, I've seen many cases of child abuse, but it's the glue really bothers people.
That would resonate with anyone, whether you're a parent or not. We also know that on the day Jocelyn was rushed to the hospital, her mother changed her Facebook profile, took the time, changed her photo to a picture of her and Jocelyn, and posted the following. She wrote this: "Why does God put obstacles in my life?" What is this mother's story, Tanya? We mentioned she's 22. How many other kids does she have? What's her background?
We don't know a whole lot about her. She's got 3 other children, ranging from 7 to 1. Given that she's 22, that means that she had her youngest at around 15. I talked to a relative yesterday who said that Elizabeth's childhood was very difficult, very rough, and the relative said she thought that Elizabeth was overwhelmed by, you know, having so many children. And she's also pregnant again, and I'm told that she's within her first trimester.
Wow.
So this will be her 5th child.
She's pregnant. She has several other kids, 3 other kids, and you said these 3 other kids are in the custody of other family members. Four other children.
No. Jocelyn and her 3 siblings are in foster care.
Okay.
Yesterday there was a court hearing, a CPS hearing. And both fathers of the 4 children appeared in court, and CPS is going to conduct home studies on both fathers to determine whether or not they're a suitable placement for the children. And, you know, difficult to say what will happen with that. But there's a court hearing November 16th where we'll find out, presumably, what will happen to the 4 children.